You have a graduated cylinder which is filled with water up to the 150 milliliter mark. So there it is right there. Then you add a hunk of iron and the water level rises to 425 milliliters. And the question asks, what is the mass of the iron? Okay, so we know we're dealing with density here. So these are the three variables that we're playing with. The question asks us what the mass of the iron is. So we know that it's going to be mass that we're solving for. Let's talk about how to get these other two variables. Okay, we're not given a volume for this piece of iron, all right? Instead, we talk about what happens with the water when we add the iron to a graduated cylinder. You might remember that this is one of the ways that we can determine the volume of something by putting it into water and seeing how much the water rises, okay? We have to do a little bit of math, but that's how we're gonna figure out the volume of the piece of iron, by looking at how much the water in the graduated cylinder moved. So that's how we're gonna figure out the volume. Now, in order to get mass, we're also gonna need to get density. This tells us that we're dealing with iron in the problem, but it doesn't tell us the density of iron. So what do you do? Well, it turns out that it's really easy to find the densities for common materials. You can get them off the internet, you can get them in books and stuff. So even though the question doesn't give us a density, we can easily figure it out. So that's how we're gonna get these two variables, and then we're gonna be able to figure out what the mass is. So the first thing I wanna do is I wanna figure out the volume of the piece of iron. And we can do that by looking at the water levels. So we're gonna take the final water level and subtract the initial water level from it, and that's gonna tell us how much it went up, and that is going to be equal to the volume of the iron that we put in there. Okay, so volume of the iron is gonna be the final reading, which is 425 milliliters, minus the initial, which is 150 milliliters, and how much it changed is gonna be 275 milliliters. Now, when we're talking about volume and density, we often use cubic centimeters, or centimeters cubed instead of milliliters. These units, though, are exactly the same quantity. So all I've got to do is just rewrite milliliters as centimeters cubed, and there is the volume for the iron. Okay? So now I have the volume for the iron, 275 cubic centimeters, and now I'll need the density. I can just look this up online really easily, and I find out that it's 7.87 grams per cubic centimeter. So now I'm ready to go. I've got the two things that I need. So I'll start with the volume, which is 275 cubic centimeters. Now, I like to use the density as like a conversion factor to go between volume and mass. So let's look at the two ways that we can write the density of iron as a conversion factor to go from volume to mass here, okay? Density of iron is 7.87 grams over cubic centimeters, which means we can rewrite this as over 1 centimeter cubed, okay? We can also flip this fraction. So we do 1 centimeter cubed divided by 7.87 grams. Which of these do we want to use? This one or this one? Well, we're hoping to cancel out cubic centimeters and be left with grams. So that means that since cubic centimeters is on the top here, we're gonna wanna choose the version of the density conversion factor that gives us centimeters cubed on the bottom. Here it is right here. We're gonna use this one. So now when I multiply through, centimeters cubed on the top, centimeters cubed on the bottom so they cancel out, and I'm left with grams. I'm gonna do 275 times 7.87 divided by 1, and the answer is gonna be 2,164.25. What do I round this to? I've got three sig figs here, three sig figs here, and the one is a counting number as part of the definition here, so we don't worry about it. So I'm gonna do 2,000, rounding it to three sig figs, 2,160. The 60 stays the same because there's a 4 here, and then I replace the 4 with the 0. 2,160, what are the units here? I canceled out centimeters cubed, so I'm left with grams. 2,160 grams is the mass of the iron. Just to review this really quickly, We needed the density of iron. We got that from the internet. That was easy. And to figure out the volume of this piece of iron, we had to look at how much the water level rose when we added the iron to the graduated cylinder. And from that, we could figure out the volume of the iron. Then we used density as a conversion factor to go from volume to mass.